So now in this class, we are going to see how to create a multiplication table. Now what is a multiplication table? Just a simple table which you see. Suppose you want to get tables of 25. Suppose you want to get tables of 15. So how can that be done using a small code? This is what we are going to see in this class. In this class, we will just see multiplication table from 1 to 10. You can change certain parts of the code to whatever you want to create multiplication for, right? So moving on, I will just write or get my first template over here. So I just need up to 10, and over here itself I need till 10, right? This is where I will create my multiplication table. Moving on, inside this I need my entire table to be there. So I'll just go to my VB editor, and in this we'll insert a new module. What are modules? We have discussed deeply in our some other class. Over here, just I'll give you a small description about a module. Modules are the places where you can write your codes. You can create more, you can write more than one procedures in one module. And also, modules are basically generally, we create more than one module. Suppose in one module we have written similar kinds of codes, like editing codes. In one module we have, so when you want to segregate your codes, your procedures, then you create different modules. That is a normal way of keeping your codes in an organized form, right? So moving on, I'll write my first code over here. When you write your code, you start with a sub. This is a procedure basically. It says public sub. By default, this is a public sub, and it will be available in all the other modules as well. So I've just written sub, and let me just keep it as a table, name of the sub. Hit enter. The moment you hit enter, you get these brackets and you get an end sub. You need to write your code between the sub and the end sub, and whatever you write between this will be executed. So for this, we need a for loop. So I'll write for, and we need two different loops to be there. One will be the loop which will go row wise, and one will be the loop which will go column wise. Now one has to be a part of the other. So there will be two loops. One will be the inner loop and one will be the outer loop. Over here in this case, you can keep columns as the outer loop, or you can keep row as the outer loop. It doesn't matter much because your code is going to be very simple. Right, when we write big loops, then it is important to make sure that what is your inner loop and what is your outer loop, and then you start writing first with the inner loop and then you write the outer loop. Okay, so we'll start from the outer loop itself. We'll say for r equal to 1 to 10. So basically it says r over here. I've taken a temporary variable r as rows. So rows, from rows 1 to 10. And then I'll just click on the tab button, and this is known as indenting. Okay, so I've indented my code, and I'll write for c equal to 1 to 10. Again, within this, I'll write my main code which needs to be run. Cells, in cells, what is the row index? The row index and the column index says you the row number and the column number where you want this thing to appear. So if I say cells 1 comma 1, then it means cell A1. If I say cells 1 comma 2, 1 meaning the first row, 2 meaning the second column. So this is B1, right? Moving on, I'll just write R plus 1 for the row index and C plus 1 for the column index equal to, I'll write R multiplied by C. So this is the basic code. R plus 1 will be the second row, C plus 1 will be the second column. So basically it says B2, and B2 you will get R into C. And then once you write for loops, you need to just say that next, move to the next C. So I'll write over here next C. And to indent it back, basically outdent, for the outdenting, you give a shortcut, shift tab, right? Shift tab, and here we write next R, and that is done. Our code is completely done. We have just a 5-liner code over here with very easy for loops, and it says for are 1 to 10. So basically you are calculating from 1 to 10, the multiplication table. Mm-hmm. If you want to create for some other numbers, then you can just simply take an input from the user, and the user might tell you that if user wants it from maybe 15 to 20, then it can say R 15 to 20, C 15 to 20. But then this will depend, the cells will depend accordingly, which is dealt in some other classes, because input box is a little trickier task to deal with, right? This is a very simple procedure which we have written, and let me just run this and see what happens. To run a code, there are two to three different ways. One simple way is to just click on this run button which you have, which says run sub, or you can just go to this debug and go to this run over here, and you can just click on the run button over here, or you can use the shortcut F5, right? So I'll just use the shortcut F5. The moment I use the shortcut F5, you see your entire table has been filled with the multiplication over here. One more cool thing which we can do is we can insert a button to run this entire macro. So let me just insert a new button. I'll go to the developer tab, and within this I'll insert a forms control, a very simple forms control button, and let me just say I want to insert it here. Now it says, which macro do you want to assign? So I'll select table, which this is the macro which I just made, and I'll say okay. Over here I'll rename this as create table. That's it. Let me just remove this and once again check. Yes, it has filled the table entirely. So this is how you create your multiplication table just by using a simple code. And also you have this button created so that the user can just simply click on this button to run this entire code. So this is it for this class. And also, when you are saving this workbook, do not forget to save it as a macro enabled workbook. To do that, we'll just click on the cross button. It says if you click don't save, so basically we need to save it as a .xlsm workbook. To do that, what we'll do, we'll simply go to the file tab over here. We'll click on the save over here, save as over here, and then you can give whatever name you want to. And in this save as type, you'll select Excel macro enabled workbook, because if you now save this as a .xlsx workbook, which is a simple Excel workbook, then it will just remove all your codes which you have written currently. It will save it as a normal Excel workbook. All the macros which you have written will be gone. To avoid that, please always save your workbook as a macro enabled workbook if you have written or recorded any macros in your workbook. Thank you. This is it for this class. In our next class, we learn some new features. Thank you.